previously during the investigation.
I'm Kaysen, Forrest Kaysen.
Thomas, did you see Nick here?
When I got here, he was already like this.
What are you doing? Get out of the way! I'll do it!
George, stay back. She's trying to speak.
No! It could be! Nick! Oh, please, no!
You got us good this time, Zach.
Oh, I can't believe it, man. Now that's heavy.
Me neither.
When did Becky stop coming to work?
I think it was like from the day Anna was killed, man. Yeah, that's right. She was totally depressed about something.
Quint called for her to let us know she wasn't coming in for work. She must have been totally in shock, the poor thing.
So you took the twins along to cheer her up.
That's right, hon. If only I knew it would be like this, I'd have spent more time talking to her.
You told me about a special secret between your children and Becky.
Yes, of course. What about it?
It seems Becky handed them an item before she was killed. Any idea what that might be?
Now that you mention it, they had a box about this size, which they said was very important.
That's it. I'd like to talk to them about this in person. Where are the boys now?
They went out, actually, with Mr. Kaysen. They mentioned going to the community center today, hon. There is plenty of space to run around over there.
Kaysen? Do you know him well?
Oh yeah, he's a good guy. He always brings us gifts from his road trips. The kids love him, so we let him take them out every once in a while. You know, for a little quality time with the missus.
Okay, I understand. But the situation calls for urgency. I'll go and look for them myself. And if they come home without running into me, could you let us know?
Sure, of course. I'll contact the department.
Where is it? Where? Where could it be? Her dress.
Oh, Sally!
Sally? Anna's mother?
She's acting up again. She's been like that ever since she heard the news.
What exactly is she doing?
Got no idea. But I guess she's in, like, you know, shock or something. Way I look at it, her daughter's death hasn't really sunk in the right way. Totally, man. I feel sorry for her.
Come on, let's go.
Lily, have you seen Anna's dress, dear? I can't find it anywhere.
Zach, the wheels are turning, but not in the right way. You feel it too?
Isaac and Isaiah aren't here. They're apparently out with Kaysen. Let's go look for them.
With Kaysen? Sounds like a long story. Any ideas where to start looking?
Lily told me where they went. No problem. And today, we're stuck here having to search for lost children.
They're not lost. We're the ones who are lost.
And so we are, Emily.
Zach, we may as well have fun if we're getting lost.
You sure know how to take your time in a time like this. I can't believe two people have been murdered in our town. And now two young children are at the center of it all. I just can't come to grips with it yet.
Crime will happen wherever there are people. And that's why we have our jobs.
Might be easier for you because you don't live here. These were people that I knew that were killed. And the murderer might be someone who lives here in this town. It's really depressing.
I know. But someone has to bring this murder to justice.
You're right, I know. But... oh, Agent York, sometimes I just think I'm not really cut out to be a cop.
Not true, Emily. You have the potential to be a superb law enforcer. You can be emotional at times, but you also possess what's most important.
I do? What do you mean?
What do you think? A sense of justice.
Justice? I must admit, I'm surprised to hear such a... how should I say this? Such an obvious answer. I thought you'd say something else.
Obvious or not, I joined the FBI in order to do what's right. And that's what's important.
I understand, but still, you seem... I'm sorry. I need some time to think.
Whatever do you want to think about?
Justice. I want to think about justice.
Zach, Zach, we're here. Let's continue our chat later. According to Lily, Isaac and Isaiah should be here.
Then let's go and find them.
Hello again, Isaac and Isaiah. I hear you're teaching Willy to do tricks. What's your secret?
It's easy.
Really simple.
If he does it right, we give him a treat.
A cookie if he does it right.
I see. You're very clever. So, tell me, you two. Could you perhaps tell me your other special secret with Becky?
No, we can't. It won't be a secret if we tell.
I'm not telling. We promised Becky.
Well, that's a problem. Because I also made a promise to Becky. To catch the bad man, but I can't keep my promise if I don't know what the secret is. Do you see?
She told us to give Diane a box. It wasn't that heavy.
We took it to the art gallery and gave it to Diane.
Is that all Becky gave you?
Just when we were leaving to take the box to Diane, Becky called us back. She handed us something. It was small and round. She told us to keep it safe in our pocket and give it to Diane.
And then you met Carol on your way?
Yep. I took the round thing out of my pocket, and we looked at it.
And then she talked to us.
We told her that we were on an errand for Becky. She said she'd do it for us.
But we told her no, because Becky asked us, not her. We promised Becky to do it ourselves.
So Becky did entrust the locket to them. And now Carol has it. Right, Kaysen?
Huh?
You were in the room when Carol took the locket back from Diane. I saw you with Diane in the art gallery that day.
Well, yeah, I was there in the room, but I was only chatting with Diane. Oh, then Carol burst in, all angry looking. While Carol and Diane had their talk, I just sat there like a frog. Yeah, so Carol took the locket from Diane, but that has nothing to do with me, right?
Yes, I believe so. But from this instant, you are now a key witness in this case. I'm afraid you can't leave town until you hear from me.
What? Can you do that? This is all starting to sound a little like Alice in Wonderland.
Which makes you Humpty Dumpty.
Huh?
Isaac and Isaiah, thank you. I think I'll be able to keep my promise with Becky thanks to you two.
How is Becky?
Is she getting better?
She'll come and help out at our store again, won't she?
She'll come and play with us again, won't she?
Boys, about Becky.
That's right. Becky is almost totally better now. But I don't think she'll be able to come and see you. I was told by Becky to keep this a secret. But she's actually a goddess of the forest, just like Anna. I think she's gonna be in the forest with Anna for a while.
Cool! We'll keep this a secret then, too.
Wow, that's why Anna and Becky are such good friends.
Okay, Willie.
You're happy too, aren't you?
Zach, I hope Emily doesn't end up as a forest goddess too. Okay then, Zach. Let's go over what we found out recently about the case.
First, Diane, the owner of the art gallery. She was out drinking with Nick Cormack in a bar on the night Anna died. Nick confirmed this, and so she has an alibi. But then we have what Nick's wife Olivia told us.
According to Olivia, Nick and Diane not only went to the bar, but also went somewhere else that night. Do you remember where that was, Zach?
That's right, the art gallery. Before entering the gallery, Diane looked back towards Olivia, almost as though she saw Olivia in the dark. Nick's behavior has also become more suspicious by the day. If Olivia is correct, then he is heavily involved in this case. But we have no conclusive evidence of that at the moment. The only thing we can say for sure is that Nick's whereabouts are unknown at the time of Becky's murder. He has no alibi for the crime, but that fact alone means nothing. So who was it that called Thomas to report trouble at Becky's place? That's right. It was Quint, Becky's boyfriend. He went to her house and saw the tragedy. Now, about Becky's murder. I'm embarrassed and mortified. Killer struck again while we were on the case. We found her bitten off tongue. A massive amount of red seeds that poured out with the blood. And an inverted peace symbol, like the one seen at the site of Anna's murder. From the similarities, one can deduce that Anna's killer killed Becky.
We also found one other important piece of evidence in Becky's room. Can you remember what that was, Zach?
That's right. We found a sketchbook in Becky's room. She had apparently written a letter to her sister Diane. It revealed that Becky took a locket from Anna's body at the crime scene. She also admitted to borrowing a pair of Diane's stiletto heel shoes So Miss Stiletto Heels was Becky.
There was something else at the end of the letter. It said that she handed the locket and stiletto heel shoes to someone. Do you remember who, Zach? That's right, Zach. And from what Isaac and Isaiah told us,
Carol offered to take the items to Diane, but the twins refused. They gave them to Diane themselves, as they had promised. For some reason, Carol wanted the locket. She ended up storming into the gallery to take it from Diane. And when Carol took the locket from Diane, Kaysen just happened to be there. Is Kaysen involved in this? Or was he just there by coincidence? I wonder what's so special about the locket, too. Why did Carol want it so badly? The questions are mounting. Come to think of it, Quint, the first witness, has no alibi for Becky's death. We checked the phone records, and his call definitely came from her house. Is it possible he attacked Becky and then called us from the scene?
But everyone is suspicious one way or another. What should we do next, Zach?
Okay, who's the most suspicious? That's right. Becky's sister and Carol's enemy, linked to both Nick and Kaysen, the elegant owner of the art gallery.
Zach, that's our next move. We'll start with Diane.
So, you want to find out everything there is to know about Diane?
That's right. There's just too many things that we don't know. First, we need more intel about the relationship between Nick and Diane.
How?
Nick and Diane meet every night at the bar. Let's use that. George, we'll need you to stake out the gallery.
What do you mean?
Wait in the parking lot of the art gallery and tail Diane when she leaves. If she goes anywhere other than the bar, you let me know. Emily, you take the diner. Wait for Nick and tail him to the bar, too. As with George, if he goes anywhere else, then you let me know.
Okay.
Thomas, you keep a watch on them inside the bar.
Yes. Yes, I will.
I'll be waiting in the parking lot of the bar. Once Nick and Diane are together, I will follow them wherever they go. What time do they usually show up, Thomas?
Around the same time. Usually between 22 and 2300.
Then at that time we do it, boys and girls.
Zach, we need to be at Carol's bar at 2200. Looks like we have some time to kill.
We can go to the diner and see how Nick and Olivia are doing.
So, Zach, this case turned into a multiple homicide.
What kind of motives turn a criminal into a serial killer? Is it hedonistic? Ritualistic? Copycat crime? Sex-related? Cannibalistic? From the Bureau's statistics. These interesting ideas don't always really explain the real motive. They're just words. Phrases that the media uses to scare citizens. The spotlight falls on a mere 1% of all cases. Only the weird ones.
You understand all this, right, Zach? No matter how bizarre a crime may appear to be, at the root, there is always rage and personal interest. Right, Zach?
Most people simply don't kill for pleasure. But that kind of common sense never applies to our investigations. Maybe we're lucky. Or unlucky, depending on how you look at it. We end up working on those cases in that 1%.
Do you remember, Zach? The first case we handled, just after becoming a special agent?
Now let's talk about this another time. I don't feel like it right now.
Zach, is there something here that you want to check out?
We need to be at Carol's bar at 2200. We're free until then. How many years ago was it now? That multiple homicide of young girls in that college town in Illinois. All the victims were cut open from the throat to the crotch. Ripped right open. During the autopsy, a second stomach was found inside the first victim's body. Of course, she didn't naturally grow a second stomach. One of the stomachs belonged to someone else. As more victims piled up, there was one with two hearts, one with two livers, four lungs. Different organs each time.
Of course, those extra organs didn't do the girls much good. Right, Zach?
And they say too much is never enough. In the end, we arrested a professor at the med school. They found the body of his daughter dead and the missing organs at his house. You remember what he said when we took him in? I was ordered to restore those deformed bodies back to normal. And remember who he said ordered him? An alien. Well, of course, we couldn't arrest an alien, so we arrested the professor instead. Serial killers can't be caught by logic and common sense. I learned this the hard way. That first case taught me that. Since then, these cases just keep getting more and more complicated. It's a tough job. I thought getting experience while I was young would make the job easier.
Nick's still in the bar.
Just as we planned, then. I wonder what happens next.
Agent York, you're really enjoying this, aren't you? I have to admit, I envy that.
Agent York, Nick is leaving the bar.
What about Diane?
She isn't here tonight.
Emily, check that with George.
George, can you hear me? Nick's leaving the bar. What's happening with Diane?
No movement.
tell me what to do here.
Stay put, George. I'm thinking Nick will head to the gallery. Let's meet up there.
10-4. Copy that.
Agent York, it's Nick.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Let's go.
Okay. Time to play with the big boys, Nick.
Thank you.
windows by now if I was driving.
I think someone's putting a curse on all the cars I drive recently.
Agent York, Nick's getting away.
Don't want the time to get serious. Hold on, you two, this might get bumpy. Is Nick here? George?
No, he hasn't showed up here.
What about Diane? Any movement?
No action here at all. Did something happen?
Yes, a little. But George, something's different about you. Are you okay?
Actually, I had a little drink while I was waiting. This is my first murder case, after all. I'm on edge, and I needed one. It was only a little, though. I'm still in control.
Zach, Nick and Diane are probably both inside.
George, you're sure you didn't see Nick?
Positive. I haven't taken my eyes from the entrance all night.
Not that I don't trust you, George, but I'm positive Nick is here. Is there another entrance?
Not that I know of.
Well, I'll go look for one. Help me out if you can, would you?
Bullseye.
Bullseye.
Nice shot.
Amazing. Great. Great. Bullseye. 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 Great. Bullseye. Great. Bullseye. Yes. Great. Bullseye. Bullseye. Nice shot. Emily, I want you guys to...
Wait out here, I know. I'm not going to fight you about this anymore. But promise me this. If there's trouble, then you'll call us in, okay? You might not think so, but we're a team.
A team?
That's what I think, at least. And I'm interested in you and Zach. I don't want anything to happen to you before I hear more about you two.
Zach, did you hear that? She wants to know more about you. Isn't that a nice surprise? Amazing.